Matt came in 1997. Obviously, Matt was a very talented athlete. We knew that both football and baseball-wise. We're excited about having Matt on our campus. Exciting player, high-energy guy, a lot of fun to be around. You know, he understood what it took to be successful at both programs, and he put in the time and worked hard, and he dedicated himself to both programs, and it paid off. Some of the things he learned in baseball, he carried on with him in football, and some of the things that he learned in football, he brought to the baseball field. So I think really playing both sports for him really helped him, and it helped us.
I think there's a shot to left over the outstretched hands of the shortstop.
Chatsworth airing it out in the opening quarter, the final 20 seconds, leading 7-0. Cassel, the keeper, touchdown.
Matt was going to come and he was going to compete and he was going to battle. He wasn't going to give in. He wasn't going to quit. And that was the neat thing about him. And he believed in his ability and he was going to compete to the end. You know, good, bad, or indifferent, he was going to get after and he was going to play hard that day. And those are the guys you want to compete with. And Matt had those qualities, also those leadership qualities. He was going to bring up the level of play of the guys around him.
I guess he just got on a bench because he slammed the single to left field.
Matt did an outstanding job of putting himself in a position to take advantage of the opportunities ahead of him. He made sure he took care of the classroom. And that's one thing we stress here. That comes first, to put yourself in a position to take advantage of the opportunities that they come up. And Matt did that. So that was great for him to go to USC as a very highly touted quarterback. What a neat thing for him and what a neat thing for the school.
Another run scoring. That's the ball game, ladies and gentlemen. The mercy rule comes into effect in the bottom of the sixth inning. Chatsworth has won their second city title here at Dodger Stadium, the final 17-7, and you can feel the excitement up here in the booth.
One of the things I'm most proud of about Matt, you hear about guys, once they get success, that they change. Well, talking with Matt and being around Matt, he's the same guy, and that's what you're most proud of, is that the success didn't change him. He's the same person, and what a success story. And for our school, our community, to be able to have a person like that, to be where he's at and be a Pro Bowl quarterback at this time, it's amazing. We're excited about watching you continue with your career. It was great having you in our program, great having you on our campus. We've really enjoyed you. Hope continued success for you in future years. And again, congratulations.
Cassel from the gun, guns it over the middle, and Chambers turns it upfield. Chambers down the sideline. Chris Chambers out of bounds inside the five. The Kansas City Chiefs closing in on a shocker.
When I first met Matt Cassel, was back on a Frost-Off team, came out, and he was like our backup quarterback, and he was also outside linebacker. And he was a better outside linebacker and a quarterback because he came out late. So, you know, he had to work his way up to quarterback. But just remember him as an outside linebacker. He would just tear it up and he was on all special teams. And you knew there was something special about him because he was a big competitor.
Cassel out of the shotgun. For Locke, inside the 5-yard line. It's first and goal for the Chatsworth Chancellors. Danny.
We went to the Coliseum in 1998, my first year. And I know Matt, he was just relaxed and having a good time. And that was what we wanted to do, is just to play our game, but relax and make the kids relax. Because I know, once again, you're at the Coliseum. It's still a 120-yard field, but it's also in a 90,000-seat stadium. And I just remember Matt being out there and seeing him and watching the film again several times, just watching him, his demeanor. He looked up at the clock, and it was just amazing watching him control the game. Matt Cassel, as a student athlete, was one of those natural smart kids. He didn't have to study to be smart. He just picked things up. And that's what was amazing about him, because he wanted, not only he studied film, but he can study film and then he'll do his homework and get it done like that. He was just naturally smart. A lot has to do with his mom. He had a great mother. His brothers and sister were just phenomenal. They're all great athletes. But a lot has to do with his mom, and everybody knows what a tremendous job that she's done with the boys and the daughter.
I'm impressed with Matt Cassel in the early stages of the first quarter. Good arm, good poise, good delivery.
Well, Matt Cassel, but a junior, 6'4", 205-pounder.
Coming out of Chatsworth to go to USC, he got the workout program from the strength trainer, and he was here. He'd come in the weight room. I'd come in early, let him in, and just he would stick to that routine exactly as it is. He wanted to be prepared. He knew he's going in, wasn't going to start, because they had at the time Carson Palmer. But you know, he wanted to learn from them, and just being in there, what a great opportunity. So he's such a fierce competitor, and you know, it's just good. You know, for the other kids, that there's always a shot. Always try your best. Never go down. I mean, he could have left USC and go somewhere else for another opportunity, but no, he stayed at USC. Just what a great exposure. It's a great education, because that was the number one thing that even the mom instilled on was education, and you're gonna get that at USC. Matt Cassel took over for Tom Brady. You knew something was special, because that week, their coach, they tried out several quarterbacks. I remember him always saying, nope, you know, we're going to stick with Matt. You know, you never like to see another quarterback get hurt, especially Tom Brady, because he's just a great guy. But, you know, it's an opportunity for him to play, and he took the most out of it. And you just look what happened to him now.
And the Chargers lose at Cincinnati. The Chiefs win the AFC West. Matt Cassel was huge today. Dwayne Bowe always big when the passing game is going. That's a 21-yard gain. Five plays later, Cassel to this year's second-round pick, Dexter McCluster, 14-yard gain.
I tell you, there is some talent on that offense, and that quarterback has found his rhythm.
Matt, what a great job. In fact, you're the one that told me in that weight room here that you were going to make it in the NFL, and look what you did. What a great opportunity. You're successful. We need some offensive linemen, but other than that, you're the man. You're great job. Singing, yeah, together we